Hi guys, welcome to my channel SWK Tot. Today we are going to model a cricket bat. So this is the cricket bat that we are going to model, and in some other video I will also teach you guys how to texture it. But in this video we are going to model it. Before I start, I just want you guys to know that I have taken this image into Photoshop and prepared separate files like these. Of front, side and back. I am going to place them into my viewports and then we are going to model it. So without any further ado, let's get started. To model it, I will go into 3 viewport. I will gonna customize it. 3 pin split left, and then in this viewport I want to go to front viewport. Then I want to go to my side view. In this viewport, I would like to go to perspective. To place the image, I will go into view, image plane, import, front, image plane, import, side. I'm going to take them slightly back. Next, I'm going to press Ctrl A or click here for attribute editor. I'm going to click looking through camera because I don't want them into my perspective viewport. I just want them into my front viewport and side viewport. Again, I will go to my channel. Now, I'm going to put into my separate layer. I'm going to name this front. I'm going to reference it. Next, I'm going to put it into separate layer. We are going to call it side. You can call it anything, whatever you like. Okay, guys. If I will be needing my backside, then I will be placing it too, but right now I don't need it. I'm going to turn off my grid. Next. First, I will model this part and then I will model this part and join it. So go to create, polygon primitives, cube. I'm going to roughly make a cube. Then I'm going to go into my shading viewport, turn on x-ray shading, turn on x-ray so that I can see through my object. I'm going to increase subdivision so that I know my center. Next, click here. Now I'm going to use my scale and move tool. I'm going to use the shortcut key R for scale and W for move. Next. Whenever I model, I normally block my object first. What do I mean by blocking is that I don't look for details. I just make its shape, basic shape. I'm going to turn it off so that I can better see my image. See, I'm not too much worried about these things that they are not following the correct reference. I just want to go with the basic shape right now. Then I'm going to click here. I'm going to press F on my keyboard. This is the part that should be here. You can see that it's getting height. This part is down and this part is slightly up. So I'm going to select the center part and I'm going to take back all the way here. Now, what I have to do is that it's looking extremely perfect till here, but very bad on this side. So I'm going to go into my mesh tools, click on insert edge loop tool, and then I'm going to click here. I'm going to use my scale tool to make it straight. And then I'm going to go here. I'm going to press Y to repeat my last tool, which was insert edge loop tool. Okay guys, so if you are going to look very carefully, this is the line flat part, or I will say, if we are going to watch our image, this is this part, this is straight, but this part, this is in a slope and it's here like this. So I'm going to come here, select this vertex, and I'm going to take it back all the way till here. Plus I'm going to select it and I'm going to take it here. Now you can see this image is not at its perfect part. Okay guys. Now I'm going to go into my insert edge loop tool again. I'm going to click here. What I normally do is that I look for places that are getting more curve. I'm going to place more edges at that part, and you can say the points that are little bit straight, I don't put too many edges there. So I'm going to select it and I'm going to very quickly adjust these lines. Again, Y to repeat the last tool. Actually, we use Y to repeat the tool and G to repeat the command. See, this is not too much difficult. All you need to know is you should have an idea how to place your edge. Now I'm going to increase my edge because there is not too much curve here. I'm dragging here so that I can select any back vertex if it has. Okay guys, so you can see my basic shape has started to appear, but still we have to do a lot of work. First of all, I need edge here to make this part smooth, and one edge here so that I can take it up. Now I have few choices. I can use insert edge loop tool here and then here, but if I am going to use my insert edge loop tool two times, I can make a mistake that they are not equal from this center part. So to get the equal edges from the center, I will use not my insert edge loop tool, but I will use my offset edge loop tool. I'm going to click here and then I'm going to click here. So now I'm going to select these two vertex and I'm going to take them up. If you are not satisfied with your position and you want to move it, double click on these edges. Now you have these edges completely selected. Confirm it. You can confirm it into your perspective view. I will go into my scaling. I'm going to click on X so that only X axis is enabled. Then I'm going to come here. My X axis is enabled and I'm going to click and hold my middle mouse, that is your scroll button, and I'm going to drag it horizontally and horizontally to adjust it. Okay, now I'm satisfied with this thing. Now I will quickly go down and I'm going to click here and here, and I'm going to bring them down too. So you guys see, it's easy. All I'm worried about right now is my basic shape, and I'm getting it. Okay, now the tricky part about to come. If I'm going to press 3 to check my smoothness, you can see it's all very, 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 very smooth. Few things. First of all, I want a hard edge here. And that hard edge should be ended here. So guys, to get a hard edge, I'm going to click on edge and I'm going to double click here. I'm going to select this edge. You guys should know this rule that if you want hardness in Maya, you should have 2 or 3 close edges. If an object has 2 or 3 close edges, it will be hard. So I will go into my edit mesh and click on bevel. Bevel divides one edge into 2 edges. You can see here. And if I'm going to increase a segment, it is going to introduce one edge over here. See? I'm going to go into my object, click on my bevel and click on T to bring it back. This menu, I'm going to reduce my fraction from 0.5 to 0.25 so that I can get a very, very hard edge. Now, if I'm going to press 3, see, this hard edge started to appear. Now, for this part like this, I want to get this part inside. This is simple straight, this is simple straight, but this part here is inside. So what I will do, I will select these edges, shift click and select these edges. Now I have seen this part, and now I'm going to bring these edges inside and slightly close to it. I'm going to release this edge because this part is not that much in. This part is extremely in, or you can say deep. So see guys, now I'm going to go into my vertex mode and I'm going to pull these edges, sorry, I'm going to move these edges slightly to this side to make this part more deep. Okay guys, now if you are going to see, we are having this kind of shape. If I'm going to press 3 now, I'm getting slight bit of this inside thing. Now I know if I'm going to press 3, part is getting curvy. To stop this curve, I can put an insert edge loop tool here, and if I'm going to press 3, then it will be hard, but I'm going to undo it and I'm going to put it later. Why, you will know in a short while. Okay guys, so that was my back vertex. I would like them to be, just for visual purpose, I would like them to be like this. And now I want 2 edges here so that I can get this shape. See that curve part? So I'm going to take them little bit down more. And now I'm going to go to my multi-cut tool. If I want a loop to be inserted, just like an insert edge loop tool, I will have to hold my control key. And if we want this edge to be at the perfect center. So I will have to click with middle mouse. In short, take your multicut tool, hold control and click with middle mouse button. Hold control and click with middle mouse button. Now I'm going to select both of them and I'm going to take them down. So you guys can see the curve part has started out. I have to go there and I have to take these things like this. You can see my bat is getting better and better, but still we have to do a lot of work. If I'm going to press 3 here right now, this part is getting very, very smooth. So what I can do to stop this smoothness is that I can go here and insert edge loop here. Now, if I'm going to press 3, you can see the problem. You can see this hard line cupping here. And if you're going to look at my reference, there is no hard line here and at this part. So remember, if there are two or three close edges, Maya is going to make a hard edge. This hard edge is good at this part, but to end it here, what I have to do is that I have to increase the distance between these edges. First of all, I am going to get rid of this edge by double clicking, selecting it, going into delete edge and vertex, and then I'm going to come into my front part. I'm going to select this vertex, both of them, front and the back one, and I'm going to increase my distance. I'm going to take it little bit up, and now I'm going to do it like this. I will try to give equal distribution to it. See guys? Okay. Plus, if you are going to look, it's a smooth transition from this part to this part. So I'm going to little bit increase its distance to, I'm going to go to my object mode and I'm going to press 3. See guys, this hard line has just ended. So remember, this is a very good trick, or you can say this is a rule. If you want to end hardness, you have to increase the distance between the edges. Next, I'm going to go to my insert edge loop tool again and I'm going to click. I'm going to insert an edge here. Now, if I'm going to press 3, you can see my shape. Next, this part, look at the hardness at this part. So, to get this hardness, I'm going to go into my insert edge loop tool and I'm going to insert an edge here and I'm going to insert an edge here. If you guys are wondering how I did this thing, so the trick is that I have pressed shift on my keyboard, I have pressed right click, and then I have taken my mouse here and release it. So this is a shortcut to get insert edge loop tool and many other options in Maya. Press 3 and you can see this part is extremely well, but still I'm going to press 1. I'm going to come up here and I'm going to look. I'm going to slightly give it a distance because I don't want too much hardness at this part. Don't worry about this thing. The image is not 100% perfect most of the time, so we have to look at our aesthetic sense for it. Now guys, press 3 and this part is done. And I'm happy with my this part. Now I'm going to come towards my top part. If I'm going to press 3, you can see extremely curved. We know we can insert an edge here. And if I'm going to press 3, it's better, but I will prefer to insert an edge here plus an edge here to hold it more. Now 3. Now you can see the hardness. This is the same hardness that I was seeing here. Okay, so this part is nearly done. What I would like to do, I would like to come here, go to my vertex, I'm not going to select back vertex. I'm just going to select this front vertex and I'm going to increase their distance. You might be wondering why I did this. Why I did not change the back vertex. The reason is that if you are going to look at your image, you can see hard line. It's still the top. If I have increased its distance, I will lose this hard edge. So I didn't do it at the back, but I did it at the front. Now, I'm going to select these two and I'm going to grow my selection. Select, grow selection, shortcut key greater than symbol, plus I'm going to delete this part, delete this part, and now I am happy with all of this thing. I will also like to get these edges slightly inside, plus these two edges inside. Now we have to make the second part. I will go to polygon primitives and then I will click on cylinder. First of all, I'm going to, or I have to count the number of vertex that are in this open face. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, so I have 14 vertex here. Why did I count this thing? I have to match the number of vertex to my number of subdivision axis. In this way, when I will model this handle, I can easily combine it and merge it at a later stage, because I'm going to join them afterwards. I'm going to increase a cap. So this is my this part. Okay guys, I'm going to select these faces, control drag to deselect them and delete these faces. Now I'm going to double click here to select this edge. I'm going to come into my front viewport and I'm going to slightly take it down more. I'm going to go to my side viewport and I'm going to look that if I need to increase it, I'm going to slightly increase it and adjust it. Next, see, I have a center edge here and this part is not having any center edge, so I'm going to rotate it so that I can get a center edge here. Okay guys, so I'm going to go into my perspective viewport, and since the number of vertex in this mesh and in this mesh are equal, I'm going to select both of them and I'm going to combine it. Now I have different options to merge these two things, but the easiest option right now is select the border by double clicking it here and then shift double clicking here. Next, I'm going to go into my bridge tool and I'm going to apply bridge. I don't want any divisions here, so I'm going to turn them off. Okay, the bridge has connected these lines and it has connected them perfectly, but I don't like one thing, and it's that the lines are flowing like this. So I'm going to go and select the faces. You can see the faces. Then I'm going to rotate them. I'm going to rotate, and yes. Whenever I'm modeling, I look for the topology and try to make it as perfect as I can. Okay guys, the next thing that is important is that I have to insert an edge here. But before I insert this edge, I am going to fix this area. See, it's not perfect. To make my life easy, I'm going to delete this edge by clicking here. You can also use the shortcut, but I'm not using it so that you guys can see what I'm doing. Okay, I'm going to select this edge. I'm going to take it down. And if you're going to look, there's too much difference between this part and this part. So I'm going to take it back like this. Because I'm also looking at this distance. I'm going to take these images, vertex up. I'm going to select this part. I'm going to take this part also back. Why I'm doing this thing? You can see it here. See the distance between these things? If you want smooth part, then you have to take care of these things. You have to be careful about your distances. The more distance you have, the more smooth it will appear. I'm going to come into my front viewport. I'm going to take it a little bit inside. Then I'm going to take it down like this. Trying to get my shape as perfect as I can. This is going to give me a very smooth transaction. I'm also going to come into my side viewport and I'm going to increase this distance too. Not too much, just slightly. See, this is not affecting my flow. Okay, this is the part that I'm not getting perfect, so it's better to take it little bit inside. Okay guys, now I'm going to quickly work on this part. I'm going to insert an edge here. Go into my side viewport. Next, I'm going to press Y again and I'm going to insert a very close edge here and I'm going to increase it. Why I'm doing this thing? You can even see that it's not in the image, but I'm doing it. The reason is that you can look at this part. It is slightly outside. So I'm going to create this thing like this. Now I'm going to go into my top viewport. I'm going to insert an edge here. And then I'm going to insert an edge here. You guys should be using some of your aesthetic senses to make things better, since, and it's very, very better if you can see a physical bed while modeling. This is going to give you a more accurate detail about the object that you are modeling. Okay guys, I'm going to go into my top viewport. I'm going to select my this vertex, and then I'm going to increase my selection or grow my selection. If you know the shortcut, then it's very, very good. Since I want you guys to since I want to show you guys this shortcut, that's why I go into this menu. But you guys should do it. Okay. Okay guys, if I'm going to press 3 here, all of these things will be very, very smooth, because there are no edges to stop its smoothness. Again, I'm repeating, if you want to have hard edges here, then you have to put close edges. Okay, this part is very, very smooth. If you remember that we have deleted an edge just to make things easy for us, now we are again going to put it back, and it is going to stop its smoothing part. See how easy. Press Y to repeat the last tool, and then I'm going to press 3 again. So guys, this is how we are going to model a cricket bat. Hope you guys like this thing. The most important part of this tutorial was the flow of edges. I made this tutorial so that you guys can learn, especially the beginners, about the flow of edges, how to make an edge close and then again increase the distance so that you can get the smoothness. Hope you guys like this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to like and comment. And in some other lesson, I will be texturing this cricket bat. So that's all guys.